In an age of social media influencers and selfies, it seems society has never placed more importance on how we look. White teeth, clear skin, beautiful hair. But what if you don't fit the stereotype? What if you don't have any hair at all? Alopecia was highlighted recently when a joke, a slap, and an Oscar winner went global. But the condition can strike anyone at any age, causing distress and a loss of identity. Jill Higgins with four very brave wahine.
Oh my goodness.
It takes a brave young girl to gather friends, family, and our cameras to say goodbye to what little hair she has left. After 3 years hoping for regrowth,
I love having hair, I love putting up hair, playing with people's hair.
15-year-old Yuane has accepted her alopecia.
Oh my God, I'm bald.
Shaving to prepare for a life wearing wigs and wanting her loss to be others' gain.
Just to show everyone that's going through it as well, they're not going through it alone. Well done. Oh my gosh.
It's kind of like a paste.
When uni student Kate gets ready in the morning, drawing on her eyebrows is something of a fine art.
And then I can just draw in my little hairs over the top. I can see it on my skin.
But her hair comes ready to wear.
When it all fell out, I was 16 and I lost all of my hair and my eyelashes, my eyebrows, just everything was gone. It's really hard to look at yourself in the mirror and say that that's you. It's quite a horrendous process as well. Like, you wake up when you've got hair on your pillow and hair in the shower. It becomes overwhelming.
Add to that the stares, the slurs.
I've been called out in parks, been called like a skinhead. You stick out like a sore thumb and people look and they're like, oh, whoa, she's bald. You can feel people's eyes on you as well, or people will like step away.
Before she got her first wig, Kate was a teenage recluse.
I didn't want to see anyone. It was just hard having to explain like what was happening to me when I didn't quite understand it myself.
Just to give you an idea.
Alopecia or hair loss can happen to anyone, male, female, young, old.
All right.
Yeah, let's go.
It's when the immune system starts to attack its own hair cells. Most commonly, it's hereditary and happens as we age.
How much longer do you think?
But stress, hormonal changes, and some medical conditions can trigger hair loss that lasts just a while or forever. Jo has alopecia universalis, meaning she's lost all the hair on her head and body.
And, you know, I always say, if you can't have hair, you may as well have tattoos. People were staring at me anyway, so let's give them something to stare at.
You don't have to brush it in the morning.
I don't have to brush it in the morning. There are silver linings.
Wow, that's so pretty.
It's unlikely that Jo's hair will ever grow back.
I had long, dark hair, fine, but lots of it. Eyebrows that I never had to pluck. Long eyelashes. Yeah.
It all started 8 years ago.
I was 42 and I didn't know what alopecia was.
In a matter of weeks, most of Jo's hair had fallen out.
There were patches everywhere. My mum shaved off the rest of it.
And just like that, she lost her sense of self.
When you are a person that has got no eyelashes, no eyebrows, no hair, your whole identity goes. It's like you're this blank canvas because your eyebrows shape your face.
A mum of three, it hit Jo hard.
Depression for about 2 years. If it wasn't for my children, I wouldn't have survived it. I felt like I was a walking freak show. I hated myself. Absolute self-hatred.
How do you think it was for your kids at this time?
I wish they hadn't seen what I was going through, but it's just me and them, and they did see.
But they've seen you come through it.
You'll see me come through it. I love you.
I love you more.
Jo had counselling to help reduce her social anxiety.
Oh my God, I haven't been hit on for a long time.
I had an amazing boss at the time, amazing. And he actually paid for me to see a private therapist once a week. I don't know how younger people do it. You've got to have a lot of support around you.
At first, Buene was good at putting on a brave face. Hair would grow back, but it wouldn't last. Then she hit high school.
I would cry. I would go to my dad. Dad, can I please stay home today? I don't want to deal with this today.
It's really hard as a parent to see, especially a young girl, going through that.
In high school, it's like so important to look nice at school. I couldn't do that.
It's hard enough for the kids to grow up with all of the pressure of social media, let alone having to be different.
Yet there was no referral for counselling.
This isn't a superficial, cosmetic thing. It goes much deeper than that. This is now very much a mental wellness thing for her. Because she looks in the mirror and she doesn't like what she sees.
They tried affordable synthetic wigs.
It really is like a Barbie doll's hair. You would quite clearly see that it was a wig. And we knew we had to go the human hair route.
But that costs thousands of dollars.
Could you afford that?
God, no. I'm a single mum. No way. No way.
As a student, Kate struggles too, working weekends to make ends meet. But she has to budget for more than rent and groceries. Her wig is now losing hair.
Here and here. And it's got some patches around the sides too of where I lifted off. So it's just like years of wear and tear.
I did like a calculation of my next wig. I'm going to have to save $80 a fortnight for 2 years just to make up the funds.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Look, you're so lovely to see you.
TVNZ sports reporter Michelle Prendeville knows she's lucky.
Yeah, I was really lucky. I came from a family who, you know, they could afford to pay for wigs like this. I mean, it wasn't easy.
But the value far outweighed the cost.
The first time you got a wig, you were 10.
I had one little bit of hair left.
I know, and I had to take it away.
At that young age, it meant everything to have normal hair because I could just be a kid. I could play my hockey and not worry about frickin' my hair falling off in the middle of a hockey game.
How different would your life have been had you not been able to have wigs?
Yeah, like it probably would have been quite different. As I look back at that little girl, and so many little girls, they have their future ahead of them. And it seems silly, it's just your hair, but it's so much more, and I wouldn't have been able to achieve the things that I did because there is a stigma around baldness.
Several weeks later, and no tears.
What more needs to be done? Because I could bloody put that on now and leave.
No.
Despite a price tag of around $5,000.
So all of these ladies put my hair together.
These wigs take 2 to 3 months of handcrafting. Each one has hair from at least 15 paid donors, and at least 80,000 hairs were implanted. They're made to look real, feel real, and they don't budge.
What kind of tea would you like?
So, like many workmates...
I didn't even know you were wearing a wig, and I would say a lot of people probably still don't.
That's good. That's how I wanted it.
It was Michelle's closely guarded secret.
What made you change your mind and decide to open up about it?
I want to help people, and so it just feels so fulfilling to now be in a position where I am open and I'm actually doing good.
Beaming out to the nation.
Welcome to Tokyo yet again.
She wants to be a role model, showing how having alopecia doesn't have to hold you back. She'd also like more help for those who need it.
I would love if we could get some extra funding.
There is a subsidy for adults of $2,300, but only once every 9 years.
So a lot of people who get these wigs, they're needing to replace them every 2-3 years, but it's not even going to cover one of those wigs, so it's ridiculous that that subsidy has to last 9 years. No one is going to be able to have those wigs last that long.
Jo thought she'd never have a human hair wig.
Oh, wow.
But 2 years ago, her stepdad cashed in his KiwiSaver to buy her this one.
And how does that feel when it's on?
I feel like a woman.
Why don't you wear it more? Because it is beautiful.
It just means it can last longer. And I wanted to get to the stage that this is okay. I don't want to hide myself 24/7.
Kate's also more confident without her wig, but having real-looking hair gives her a different kind of freedom.
You get to choose how you're going to have your hair today. If you have it up, you have it down. With alopecia, it's hard to have that choice. And people tend to take their first judgment of you based on the way that you look.
It's just to make sure the scanner knows exactly where you're positioned.
Kate's parents have lent her the money for her next wig.
Eyes closed, starting.
Her head is scanned to ensure it's a perfect fit. She can't wait.
You want to feel you are your age and you want to feel pretty when you look in the mirror in the morning.
Because every day, wherever we are, whatever we're doing, there'll be a moment when we catch sight of ourselves. And it's important that we recognise and like the person staring back. Ioane is now the proud owner of her first human hair wig.
Looks amazing.
Yeah, I love it.
Are you happy with it?
Yeah.
Are you going with
it? I put it on and I just felt like a whole different person. It was definitely one of the best moments that I've ever experienced in my life.
She feels like she fits in again.
I don't have to worry about people looking at me. I just put it on, tie it back, and I just go for it.
Are you ready for your big makeover?
Today, a special celebration with friends.
Have you had your makeup done before?
Mm-mm.
Her mum, Yolandi, knows that in an ideal world, Ioane's happiness wouldn't rest with the hair on her head, and they're working on that.
It's just really finding those words of encouragement to really let her know that her hair isn't her character. It's not who she is.
Oh my God. Such an amazing job.
But right now, it's what she needs.
Yes.
And her mum believes it should be more affordable for anyone who's lost their locks.
I absolutely hear when people say it's not a life-threatening thing, but mental illness is, and I would never want for anybody to feel like they are not worth living a good life for something as simple as a wig.
1, 2, 3,
okay!
Yeah, well, after being petitioned to increase current wig subsidies, the Ministry of Health has said it will consider the issue as part of a broader review of health and disability funding.